The latest aerial footage from Pakistan showing what's being called the flood of the century.
Pictures from Indian television show the water overwhelming large areas of the coast.
You can see on this hillside, many of the houses have collapsed, sliding down into the lower houses. The devastation is unimaginable.
Some tents have been set up, but for many, shelter is hard to come by.
Downtown Port-au-Prince, I meet this family. 20 people living in a 10 by 10 space.
Despite the massive relief effort, there's been criticism of the government response in some areas, with complaints help has been slow to arrive.
Our research was inspired by two goals: disaster relief and sustainability.
Every year, thousands of families are displaced from their homes due to natural disaster.
Many current solutions for relief efforts lack either effectiveness or sustainability. Our research fulfills both of these demands with one simple solution: the bamboo gridshell.
A gridshell begins as a flat grid of structural elements and is raised into its desired dome-like shape. Once formed, the gridshell is strong, lightweight, and uses minimal resources. With an organized instruction set, a gridshell can be built in just hours, requiring little skill and only a few common tools. These are all the desirable qualities for a rapidly deployable emergency shelter.
One concept that makes this design unique is the idea that every component will already be available at the location of the disaster. Bamboo and zip ties are both commonly available resources in many parts of the world. This allows a more immediate response to a natural disaster.
We established our constraints and created several alternatives for each component of the design. After a cost-benefit analysis of each alternative, the overall design was refined into a final product. Our bamboo gridshell is simple, sustainable, and quick to construct.
The initial concern when designing a gridshell is form finding or modeling, basically finding the shape that this flat grid is going to take when you deform it under some force. To do that, we use a software called SolidWorks. It's a very visual and easy to use software, and it's made this task very easy and effective for us. At the same time, we've been using another text-based application called MATLAB to do a more rigorous and mathematical analysis.
In order to model both the design and the life cycle of our grid shell, we collected certain experimental values by means of testing. A bending test allowed us to acquire the necessary material properties for design. These values were then utilized in a computer simulation. A grid deflection test was designed to obtain a grid stiffness for assessment of life cycle impacts. This data was then analyzed along with the GFRP as a direct comparison.
The greatest influence in choosing our design material was sustainability. GFRP composites have been the choice material for grid shells in recent years, but our research shows that bamboo has the potential to be a more sustainable option. With the right farming techniques, bamboo can have far less environmental impact while sharing similar material properties with GFRP.
The functional unit forms the basis of comparison between two products. For our life cycle assessment, we evaluated our structure based on the stiffness of the material. Creating two grids, one of bamboo and one of GFRP, with the same stiffness coefficient, we were able to fairly compare the two materials. The assessment was done using SigmaFed, which allows us to analyze the environmental performance of the materials used in the grid shell.
We were very lucky to spend time researching in Rio de Janeiro, Brazil, where we were able to extend our research even further by working with bamboo in the structures lab of Puki. We gained so many different experiences, not only learning about different bamboo species, but also learning to adapt and adjust to situations like a language barrier and a different pace of work.
Our team was again so fortunate to be able to combine our research with tourism, unique cultural experiences, and social exchanges. We danced to live samba music, cheered on soccer teams at a match, indulged in some amazing and flavorful foods, and hiked up to beautiful overlooks of the city of Rio.
Together, the Mascaro Center for Sustainable Innovation and the National Science Foundation have given us an extraordinary opportunity. This program has given us access to educational and cultural experiences that made our research program unique from any other.